So sir, how are you doing?
Hi, very good, thank you.
How was your whole day? How was the experience of the 4th BFSI CTO Summit?
I think it was excellent. I think the crowd that we have here and the panelists, the speakers, the content that is being covered is excellent. And more importantly, the lot of partnership opportunities that we see here and the kind of stalls that we see here are extremely elaborate, they're very comprehensive, covering a variety of technology and services. So it's been a great day, a lot of learning.
Okay. So please give us an overview of your products and services.
So we are an IT services company specializing in analytics, but I think within analytics we are extremely focused on credit risk for banking, also looking at risk as an aspect of consulting for different financial institutions. So we work with a variety of lending institutions, like including banks, whether it's private or government, or it's whether it's NBFC or fintechs, or insurance, general insurance, life insurance alike. So we kind of, with about 4 decades of our industry experience in analytics, especially on the business consulting side, where we just not only talk about technology, but we also bring a lot of best practices in terms of business understanding about the processes, about their different methodologies, the way of doing business. So that kind of helps us kind of fit in the business aspect and the technology together. And as a service provider, we also work with the best of the lot in the industry. So we work with the best OEM providers, with the best software vendors, and we kind of give a best fit solution for our customers based on what they need at that point in time.
Okay. So how you feel the technology is changing the face of BFSI sector?
I think one word to describe all of that put together is certainly automation. It's digitization and also trying to have less and less of manual intervention in any processes that are there in the industry today. So from an automation standpoint, obviously there is an element of how can we rely more on systems, how can we automate our decisioning process, how can we kind of give a faster tag to a customer, how can we give a faster data to our agencies on the field or sales feet on the ground to get them better throughput and better turnaround time for the customer experience. From a digitization standpoint, I think everything has gone digital, from being paper to paperless, from being judgmental to more, from a scoring perspective, more technology inputs have come in to help them make decisions on lending. So we kind of have offerings in all these different areas. So we not only provide automation services, we also provide technology services. So I think these two things are really changing the face of how banks are interacting with their end customers.
So what are the innovations you're planning to implement in your company in the next 2 years, say next 2 years? Because talking about 5 years is very long period.
So I think we have been traditionally looking at analytics with data management, predictive modeling, decision automation. This is the fundamental building blocks. But I think that will not go away. I think what we certainly feel is increasing the level of, given that the data is increasingly becoming more and more richer in terms of not just customer data, but there are also a lot of surrogate information coming in from different industries and channels. We want to kind of start looking at what different algorithms we can explore to kind of utilize and tap onto that information and make meaningful decisions. It could be ML, it could be deep learning, it could be any elements of AI to that effect. So I think we're also trying to build multiple practices in that area. We're trying to do POCs with some of our clients today on automating the decision science as an area where, given that we can structure some data and put it into an engine and automatically certain models, decisions will come out. So we're kind of looking at that area to see how we can bring down the decision science aspect of building models, from a traditional 3 to 4 month period to about less than a month, and then how can we make it more and more accurate without manual intervention. So I think the element of automation is there again, and then again, algorithm wise, we're looking at different stuff like ML, AI, and those deep learning or XE Boost or those algorithms as well.
Thank you so much, sir, for your time.